டாக்டர் பி கனகலட்சுமி, அசிஸ்டன்ட் ப்ரொஃபஸர் ஆஃப் இங்கிலீஷ், விவி வணிய பெருமாள் காலேஜ் ஃபார் விமன், விருதுநகர். நவ் ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு டாக் அபவுட் இன் திஸ் வீடியோ த ஸ்கார்லட் லெட்டர் சாப்டர் 3, த ரெகக்னிஷன். இன் த க்ரௌட் ஹெஸ்டர் சாய் அ ஃபிகர் ஹூஸ் ஷோல்டர் ஷீ ரெகக்னைஸ்ட். ஐ திங்க் ஹியர் வி கம் டு நோ தட் இன் த க்ரௌட் மெனி பீப்புள் வேர் ஸ்டாண்டிங் தேர் அண்ட் அமிட்ஸ் தட் All the people are looking at her with contempt only, but even then, in that crowd, she is able to recognize someone, particularly someone, and whose shoulders she is familiar with. So, who is that person? Stranger to the place known as Roger Chillingworth asked the reason for Hester standing on the scaffold. So, the person whom Hester friend identified was none but her husband. Her husband, and now, in this place, He is a stranger to that place, and here now he is known as Roger Chillingworth. And then Roger Chillingworth actually doesn't know anything about that, and so he asks the people in the crowd why that lady is standing on the scaffold, what is the reason, and all the people have gathered here, what is the reason, like that he asks. And then the people replied that this lady she came to this place some 2 years back, and her husband was a learned man, and after coming to this place, this lady has committed a sin, and so only she is standing on the scaffold, like that the people explain. And then they also say that the wife of a learned man sent his wife before him 2 years in Boston. So the people in Boston know Hester Prynne only for 2 years. And they also came to know that her husband was a learned man. So they don't know anything about his name or about his profession, anything like that. But they only know he was a learned man. So the people in the crowd, the women, they say that her husband was a learned man, and he has sent her before him to go, and she has been told by her husband that he will follow him, but he didn't follow her. So only for 2 years she has been living there in Boston, a lonely life. And then the penalty for adultery is death, but stand for 3 hours and wear the letter for the remainder of her life as a mark of shame. And then the women also, the people in the crowd, they also explain that As she has committed the sin of adultery, she has to wear the letter A, and she has to stand there on the scaffold for 3 hours, and for the remaining of her life till her death, she has to wear that letter A in her bosom. Like that, the people in the crowd explain things to Roger Chillingworth, who is the husband of Hester Prynne. And then Governor Billingham, who is there with the 4 surgeons, and then John Wilson, the oldest clergyman of Boston, he asked Reverend Mr. Dimmesdale, who is his brother, to ask Hester Prynne to reveal the name of the partner of sin. And then a young clergyman and brother of Wilson, who is Mr. Dimmesdale, he comes to the front, and he asks Hester Prynne to reveal the name of girl's father, the baby's father. And then here he is not asking Dimmesdale, he is coming to the front and he is asking Hester Prynne, but he is not asking in a very strict manner. He is simply in a polite way, we can say, he is asking Hester Prynne to reveal the name of the father. But Hester Prynne sternly says that, "And my child must seek a heavenly father. She shall never know an earthly one." Here Hester Prynne, she is very stubborn, and she says that, "My baby, my child must seek a heavenly father. There is God only." So her father is God only. She shall never know an earthly one. In the earth, she shall never know an earthly father, like that she says. And then with his hands upon his heart, drew back, saying, "She will not speak." Now, Dimmesdale, he himself says that, and while saying, he is keeping his heart hands in his heart, and he is saying that she will not speak. It is not the opinion of the other people, or here not Hester Prynne is saying, I will not speak like that, but Dimmesdale is saying she will not speak, and then keeping his hands on his heart, he is moving back. And then as Hester Prynne is not revealing the name of her partner in the sin, she is again, after 3 hours, she is taken back to the prison. Chapter 4, the interview. Hester, in a state of excitement, and child was also ill. And now here we see Hester Prynne, as she stood there in the scaffold for 3 hours, she was not feeling well, and the child was also not feeling well. And she looks like a possessed woman. The jailer who has been there, that is a Master Brackett, the jailer, he thought that the look of Hester Prynne, it looks as if she is possessed by some devil like that. So she is she must be not feeling well like that, he thought. So he went and brought the physician, and the physician is Roger Chillingworth. And when Roger Chillingworth came there, he wants to talk with Hester Prynne alone. So what he's saying is, he's asking all the people to leave them alone, and he assures that he will take care of his patient. So Roger Chillingworth asked the jailer to leave him alone with his patient. And then the prison keeper left, examined the child, and mixed medicine with water and gave it. After some time, the baby had a good sleep, and then examined Hester and gave medicine for her. First, Roger Chillingworth, he was examining the baby, and he was mixing some powder with water, and then he was giving it to the child. And he also examined, here Hester Prynne also was mentally as well as physically not feeling well. So he was also giving medicine to Hester Prynne. At first Hester Prynne thought that Roger Chillingworth was giving only poison to her child. But Roger Chillingworth says that he accepts, why should I kill your child? It is your child. I don't have any rights to kill your child. Okay? Like that he says. And then here Hester Prynne also takes the medicine, and she is also relieved of the physical pains. And then accepted his folly, a bookworm of great libraries. So what had I to do with youth and beauty like thine one, mishappened from my birth? Now here Roger Chillingworth is meeting his wife after 2 years, and now he accepts his folly, and he says that he is the reason for the sin committed by Hester Prynne, and so he accepts his sin, and he apologizes to Hester Prynne, and he says that, what can I do? I have, when I married you at that time itself, I am a elderly person. And then he also says that, from my birth hour, I am only interested in reading books and gaining knowledge. So what shall I do? So it's not my mistake. Okay. So from my birth, I have been interested only in knowledge, gaining knowledge. And he also says that, what had I to do with youth and beauty like thine own? He accepts that, I am not able to understand your beauty or your love towards me. So it is my mistake. Like that, here Roger Chillingworth accepts his mistake. And then recollects his marriage with Hester, and Hester standing in a statute of ignominy before the people. And then here, on looking into Hester Prynne, Roger Chillingworth also recollects his past. His past when he came out of the church. Okay, both Roger Chillingworth and Hester Prynne, how they came out of the church like a pair. That he is recollecting, and again he is recollecting the figure of Hester Prynne standing on the scaffold. And he feels that only he is responsible for the sin committed by Hester Prynne. And so he says that, I am the person responsible for the mistake, or what are the things you are undergoing, the tortures or the painful experiences which you are experiencing now. I am the responsible for all this. Like that, Roger Chillingworth accepts. And then she says, I have greatly wronged thee. Then Hesterton also accepts that. I think when I married you, I told you frankly that I didn't love you. That is, you are an elderly person and I also don't have any love for you. So I frankly told you. Like that, Hesterton also accepts that. I have greatly wronged thee. And then, conceal the truth from the people, from the magistrates. He may not have the letter of infamy on his garments, but shall read it in his heart. Then, here again, Roger Chillingworth asks Hesterton, who is the father of her baby? And again, Hesterton is very stubborn to tell. She says that I will not tell the name of the baby's father like that. And then here, Roger Chillingworth says that, okay, you need not tell the name. He may be a person of a great fame, so that he must the fame may cover the name of your baby, the father of the baby. But I will find out in his heart. Here, Roger Chillingworth is very particular to find out who is that person. Okay, who has wronged both Hesterton as well as himself. So he is saying that it may not be revealed openly in public, but I will find out. When I look into his heart, I can find out that he is the father of your baby, like that he says. And then on hearing the words of Roger Chillingworth, Hesterton was afraid. Thy acts are like mercy, but thy words interpret thee as a horror. Here, Roger Chillingworth came and gave medicine to the baby and gave medicine to Hesterton, and both of them, they feel well. The baby is sleeping well. And then here she is referring to that. The acts are like mercy, but thy words interpret thee as a horror. So I am afraid how you speak, your words shows your horror, like that she says. And then kept the secret of Paramore in the same way, keep his secrets also. He asked the reason why he did not want to tell the public that he is her husband, because it is a shame for him to be the husband of a faithless woman. She promised not to reveal the truth. Now here Roger Chillingworth is asking Hesterton, so you are not telling the name of your husband, okay? You need not tell the name of the child's father, but in the same way, you also should not tell the public that I am your husband. And here, Hesterton asks, why you are not ready to tell the public that you are my husband? And then here, Roger Chillingworth says that the public will look at me. So he is the person, husband of that faithless woman, like that the people will say. So I am not ready to accept that. I don't want to get that comments. So you keep this as a secret. And then here Hesterton promises, okay, I will not reveal the truth. Here in this chapter we come to know about how the two persons, the one is the partner of Hesterton's sin, who is along with her, but who is not ready to come and accept the punishment before the public, first one. And the second person, Roger Chillingworth. Roger Chillingworth also not ready to tell the public that he is her husband. So both the men are not ready to accept the shame or punishment before the public, but the woman, Hesterton, she is ready to accept the punishment and lead her life. Chapter 5, Hester at her needle. Hesterton was released from the prison. The chain that bound her to that present place could not be broken. Her fellow sinner and her fellow sufferer lived at the same place. So this place was the scene of her guilt. It should be the scene of her earthly punishment. After some time, Hester was released from the prison. And here, when she came out of the prison, she had a confusion whether to live in that place or to escape to some faraway place or to hide in a place, or she can start her life in a new way without telling the people that she has committed the adultery, like that. She need not wear the letter in other places. Wherever she goes, people will not follow her. So she can take out the letter and then she can start a new life. But she felt that this is the place where she has to lead his life. The reason is, here only her fellow sinner and fellow sufferer. Here, Hester Prynne, she is feeling that the sinner who has committed sin along with her, and then sufferer. As he did not accept the truth before the people, he is suffering. So she feels that he is also a sufferer. Okay. So she wants to live in that same town. At the same time, she feels that the place of the scene of her guilt should be the scene of her earthly punishment. When she faced the people there, that is also a shame for her, and she also accepts that. She is ready to accept that shame, and she feels that it will be the earthly punishment for her sin. So she felt that she has to live in that town. She took up her lodging in a small thatched cottage at the outskirts of the town. She earned her living by her needlework. Her needlework was seen on the ruff of the governor. Military men wore it in their scarves, and the ministers on his band. It decorated the baby's little cap, and it was shut up in the coffin of the dead, not allowed to embroider the white veil which covers the bride. Hester Prynne was very good at doing needlework, which we can see in chapter 2 itself, where the women in the crowd, they say that she has no bothering about wearing that letter A, because she has embroidered it with the red and gold, that all the people, they wonder at the beauty of that embroidered letter A. They look at the beauty only. They are not looking at that A stands for adultery, but it is very beautiful, the letter A on her bosom. So she is very good at her needlework. So from the governor to the small baby, even the small baby, for every person, she is able to do her needlework. And even in the dead person's coffins, there also her needlework was there. But in only one place she was restricted, that is, she is not allowed to embroider the white veil, which is used to cover the beauty of the women who are going to marry. So that alone she is forbidden to embroider. And then bestowed all her means in charity, garments for poor, penance in this occupation. She was patient and prayed for her enemies. Here, whatever she earned through her needlework, she spent for herself and her baby's food. And then apart from that, she spent for other people. That is, she gave the people who are in need of money, or she embroidered cloths for the poor people. Like that, she helped the people who are in need. In this way, she was only spending her time, or her occupation was helpful in helping others. And then she was patient and prayed for enemies. And this doesn't mean that the people have accepted Hester Prynne without her guilt. The people's attitude is the same. They look at her with contempt only. So here, sometimes people may openly speak before her, or they may say her that, see how she is walking, okay, without any shame like that. She patiently underwent all the sufferings and even prayed for her enemies. This shows the character of Hester Prynne, how she is very patient, and how the decision made by her. So I have to undergo shame in this place. So that is the punishment for me. So she is going all the punishment in a patient way. In all her movements and activities, she felt that people regarded her as one who did not belong to them. So people were only keeping her aloof. That is, she is an adulteress. She has committed a sin, like that only. So in all her movements and activities, she felt that, okay, the people are keeping her away from them only. They are not accepting her as one among them. Clergymen deliver sermons on chastity, adultery and sin. Children followed her and shouted her. When clergymen, when they happened to cross her in the street, then at once they started telling people there about the adultery. Okay, why you should not commit adultery. So if you do this, then what are the punishments you will be getting, like that. They will be preaching people. whenever they come across a Hester print, the clergymen, they started doing like this. And then the children, small children, they followed her. They kept a distance only, but even then they shouted at her, and then the letter A, okay, everything they shouted. Living in such miserable situation, she thought whether she was the only one that committed sin. And sometime here, Hester Prynne has made up her mind to accept or undergo all the punishment in that place or the tortures, everything. But at some time she felt that whether she is the only person who has committed that sin in this whole world. Like that, she feels very bad also sometimes, but she doesn't give up her hope. She lives her life in a way for her child, and as well as she also tries to help the poor people. Thank you.